Hi guys, in this video, we will be doing an in-depth camera comparison between the $1100 iPhone 12 Pro Max, which is considered one of the best camera phone of 2020, and a $2000 mirrorless full-frame camera Sony Alpha 7 Mark III. So let's get started. In this video, we will be comparing daylight shots, indoor, low light and portrait shots along with video samples for comparing the stability and focus speed. There has always been a debate whether a smartphone can replace professional camera for casual photography. Of course, phones can't do what DSLRs can do in terms of professional photography as they have tons of different settings. But for amateur photographers, is it worth spending so much money on a full frame camera? We will find out in this video. iPhone 12 Pro Max has three 12 megapixel cameras at the back, a wide angle, a telephoto, and an ultra wide angle lens. You can see the detailed specifications on your screen. And to be fair, we have gone for a 2870mm Sony lens for our Alpha 7 Mark III to somewhat match the focal length of iPhone. Sony Alpha 7 Mark III has a 24.2 megapixel sensor. For this comparison, we will be using intelligent auto mode on the camera, which will do the required ISO and other settings on its own for optimal shot. And as you all know, iPhone doesn't come with a manual mode, so everything is set to auto by default. So these are some of the daytime shots. The pic from the iPhone is a bit brighter, whereas Alpha has captured a darker image with more contrast. Both look stunning and have beautifully captured the details of the flower, but Sony has slightly more details due to more megapixels. Here's another shot, and the saturation and contrast is more on the Alpha compared to iPhone, whereas iPhone has gone for a softer color tone, which looks pleasant to the eye. Alpha has a much larger sensor, and this results in more shallow depth of field, as you can see the background is blurred on the Alpha, whereas the leaves are still in focus on the iPhone. Even in this sample, the Alpha has bumped up the colors and contrast, whereas iPhone's shot looks more natural. Details are of course much sharper on the Alpha, and this continues in most of the shots. This shot has been taken at 2.5x optical zoom. Although at this point there's not much difference, but if we crop it further, we can see that the iPhone has sharpened the image for better details. This shot looks amazing on both the devices, only the color of the leaves is a bit odd on the Alpha. And I have noticed it in most of the shots that the greens are not accurate on the Alpha and they have a slight yellow tint. The iPhone seems to have better details when zoomed in. The iPhone shot is brighter over here and the sky details are well maintained, whereas the sky looks washed out on the Alpha. Here, I prefer the pic from the Alpha due to the accurate colors and it has slight depth of field at 2.5x zoom. Here's a video sample to test out the colors and stabilization. Both of them have image sensor shift technology, but the Alpha has stabilization in the body and not in the lens, and as you can see the video is much more stable on the iPhone 12 Pro Max. In terms of colors, both are doing really great. Alpha seems to have more saturation, but it comes down to personal preference. Here's another video sample, and the HDR is slightly better on iPhone 12 Pro Max. The Alpha is blowing out the details where there is harsh sunlight, especially the sky color is not accurate. Here we are testing out the focus speed, and the iPhone has an amazing focus speed thanks to the LiDAR sensor. Quite impressed with it. This video is from the Alpha, which has one of the best focus speed in the professional camera category, and it's working really well. Not as fast as the iPhone, but still it's good. One advantage of high-end phones nowadays is that they have wide, ultra-wide and telephoto lens in such a compact body. Whereas for DSLRs, you have restrictions. You can have a wide-angle lens with zoom or a separate ultra-wide-angle lens. You have to purchase them separately and some of the lenses are quite expensive. So this is the normal shot. And this is the ultra-wide shot from the iPhone on the left, whereas our Alpha doesn't have an ultra-wide-angle lens. And this shot has been taken at 2.5x optical zoom. As I told earlier, the greens are not accurate on the Sony Alpha. They have a yellow tint. The colors are more accurate and balanced on iPhone 12 Pro Max, whereas the saturation and contrast in the Alpha pics doesn't look pleasing to the eye. Of course, these all things can be solved by post-processing or by manual settings. Now let's compare the portraits. In this first shot, both are doing an amazing job. The skin tones and edge detection is perfect. The only difference is that Sony has more saturation. But this shot clearly shows that portrait photos from smartphones can't match the edge detection of portrait photos from a camera. As you can see, the hair, some part of the beard and shoulder has been slightly blurred out on the iPhone, whereas the edge detection is perfect on the Alpha. But the details are slightly better on the iPhone. Even here, the iPhone has blurred out the springs at the bottom, whereas it's in focus on the Alpha. And the same thing continues in other shots as well. But due to LiDAR sensor, the edge detection has improved a lot compared to previous iPhones. Thankfully, iPhone 12 Pro Max has night mode in the portrait mode from primary camera, so you can capture portrait photo even without zooming, but it's not possible on the Alpha. But when you shift to 2.5x optical zoom for portraits, here the Sony Alpha A7 is the clear winner as it can absorb more light due to bigger sensor, whereas due to small sensor and no night mode, it's nearly impossible to capture photos from telephoto lens in extremely low light conditions. But the edge detection is still great thanks to the LiDAR sensor. Here are some of the HDR shots, and the iPhone has maintained the details of the sky, but the tree on the left is completely black, whereas the Alpha has slightly blown out the details of the sky, whereas it has maintained the details of the tree to a certain extent. Here the iPhone has captured a better shot, maintaining a perfect balance between the details and colors of the foreground and the sky, whereas the Alpha has captured a darker image with a slightly blown out sky. Both of them have done a great job in this shot. The only difference is in their color tones. Here, the iPhone has captured a darker image but has perfectly maintained the details of the foreground and the sky, whereas Sony has brightened up the foreground and has slightly blown out the background. Not much difference in this picture, both are doing great. Now in this photo, the iPhone has perfectly captured the color tones of the sky. You can easily guess from the iPhone's pic that it's an evening shot, whereas the Sony didn't capture the details and colors of the sky perfectly, but the foreground is brighter. And if we crop further, we can see the iPhone has over-sharpened the image to show more details, whereas the Sony has a soft output. Here, although the colors are similar, but the image from the iPhone is brighter. Same thing continues over here as well. So it's obvious that evening shots are better on the iPhone, as all the images from the iPhone are brighter with better color reproduction and sky details. But if we don't zoom from the camera, instead crop the image from a PC, then we can definitely see that the 24.2 megapixel sensor captures much more details than the 12 megapixel camera of the iPhone. In this video, iPhone is the clear winner when it comes to HDR, as the sky and foreground details are well maintained, and still the video is brighter on the iPhone, whereas the sky is getting blown out on the Sony, and still the foreground colors and details are not properly maintained. These are some night shots, and night mode was set to auto on the iPhone, and you can see there is not much difference in terms of exposure. Only the highlights are slightly blown on the Sony and the color production is different. iPhone photos are a bit sharper. In this picture, the night mode on the iPhone has helped to capture a better image, whereas the Alpha's photo is a bit darker and has slight noise as well. Here the iPhone has perfectly captured the colors, highlights and details, whereas the colors from the Sony are a bit odd. The lights are slightly blown out and the details in the dark areas are crushed. Here, I prefer the pic from the Sony Alpha due to natural shallow depth of field and pleasing colors. Here, although Sony has slight noise, but it has captured accurate colors, whereas the iPhone has a yellow tint. In this pic, the iPhone is the clear winner as it has maintained the details of the lights to a certain extent, whereas Sony has blown out those details, so the night mode on the iPhone does make a huge difference. Here, the Sony has captured better colors, although it has some noise, but I prefer the Sony pic. Not much difference in this picture except for the saturation and color tone. Now we'll move to indoor shots, and except for the shallow depth of field, there's not much difference in this picture. Both are doing really great. Here the iPhone is slightly brighter with right exposure. In this photo, Alpha has moved to a blue tint, but the colors on the iPhone are more accurate and the light details are well maintained. The same thing continues over here as well. So both of them have done an excellent job in this comparison. The iPhone was better in HDR and low light photos along with video samples, whereas Sony Alpha A7 Mark III was better in portraits, especially night portraits. Daytime shots were excellent on both of them, except for some color accuracy issues on the Alpha, and all those things can be easily solved by manual settings or by post-processing. So can a smartphone replace an expensive camera for casual photography? The answer would be yes, as smartphones' cameras have improved a lot in the past couple of years and they offer much more in a compact size, and without any need to tweak the settings. Professional cameras, be it Sony, Canon or Nikon, all of them have auto mode, but they are not yet properly optimized to be comparable to high-end smartphones. So comment below, what are your thoughts? Can a smartphone replace a professional camera? Please let me know in the comment section below. If you enjoyed the video, do hit the like button. Also, don't forget to click the subscribe button and press the bell icon to get updates on our new video uploads. Also, follow me on Instagram on techbuzz.insta page and techbuzz Facebook page. We will be back with another video soon. Till then, stay tuned.